Okay, my name is Gaston Ravin Dias. Most of my friends call me Ravin. From Sri Lanka, my hometown is Manna. It's north part of Sri Lanka. Then I went to Colombo to continue my bachelor's. I studied there, then I went to Jaffna to work there. I used to work nearly 1 year in Jaffna. Then I had a chance to came here to study my master's in Malaysia at UM.
I'm a Sri Lankan, Manzoor Muhammad Fazil. Actually, you know, I did my bachelor degree at the Southeastern University of Sri Lanka. Then I got an appointment as a permanent lecturer at the same university. Then I got a scholarship from the Japan International Cooperation Agency to pursue my master degree in political science at the Meiji University, Tokyo. And I have completed 2 years full-time degree with the research component. Then I returned back to the country and work at my same university for some time. Thereafter, I think to move for my PhD.
I finished my bachelor's in 2016 actually. So at the point when I finished my bachelor's, I started to work in industry. So while working in the industry, I had many ideas. How can I develop my career in clinical side as a biomedical engineering student or maybe in an industry man. So while doing in industry, I had some contacts with my senior people and the doctors, the other company staffs, and they said, at the moment, to be honest with you, at the moment in Sri Lanka, they don't have a good opportunity for biomedical engineers. Still, they are called biomedical technicians. So though how many years I'm having the experience, that's not concern. So let's say I'm having 5 years of experience, I have to be there as a biomedical technician. So I had an idea that it is not pointless, because if I have worked continuously in Sri Lanka as the same hospital, or maybe if I change the hospital, I'm going to be in the same level of my life. So I just want to improve myself, so that's why I chose to study masters.
I want to go to a prominent university, and I have to learn from a prominent supervisor about the research culture and the university culture. So I have searched over the through the internet about universities in the Western, at the same time the one of the ASEAN universities, and finally I have found University of Malaya is one of the prominent university and one of the growing institution in the Asia. And I heard that this UM targeting to come into the 100 place, into the 100, top 100 of the UK based QS ranking system. So I heard that this university going, getting but improving to reach that particular point. So thereafter, I have seen the profile of the academics at this university, and I have seen most of the academics at this university, they studied their PhD and further in UK universities and US universities. Then I decided finally to apply to the UM.
So two things I had to consider. First, the place where I am going to study must be affordable to me. And the other one is must be safe for my studies. That means a recognized one, right? So I just chose Asian countries because I can afford to study in Asian countries rather than studying in European countries. When I was applying, my application process was in 2017, 2018. So that's the period when I applied. So at that time, the course fee for the master course, what I'm doing, is nearly 40 to 45 lakhs. Right? I think comparing the same masters with European countries, this one is much cheaper. So let's say if I want to do the same master course in Australia or Canada, as I told you, I have to pay nearly 90 lakhs to 1 crore. So if you compare about the prices, this one is cheap, and rather than the price, the university accreditation is good. It's a top-ranked university. So I'm paying less money comparing to the European countries, and I'm getting the good accreditation.
Through my study, I'm contributing to the existing knowledge in the way of empirical and the theoretical. So to make me to this stand and brought this kind of the knowledge by Professor Edmund Terence Comas, I'm always happy with him. At the same time, other professors at my faculty and the university, you know. When I face some problem, you know, I do meet other professors also. Even they teach, they taught me the subjects. So they, everyone, very student friendly, and they are willing to make us as a good academic in the field of the economics and the political science. And I'm really proud and I'm really thankful to my supervisor particularly and other professors at this university.
I feel this one is very good for international students, especially for my Sri Lankan friends and brothers. It's a good university to choose to continue your higher studies. My experience about UM is very good because comparing to the bachelor's where I did in Sri Lanka, I had many advanced subjects. You know, in Sri Lanka when I did my bachelor's, I had some fundamental ideas how the field is going to be in future. But in UM, I'm just studying the advanced subjects, which is specially designed for the careers for biomedical engineers in future. So for an example, I can tell you artificial intelligence. That's one of the novel subject which is going to be in future. We are learning that now. And rehabilitation engineering, that's a dedicated field in biomedical engineering. And so far we have many subjects specially designed for biomedical engineers, so we can improve our future by learning these new techniques through the subjects.
Actually, I'm happy to live in Malaysia, you know. I'm from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka also multi-ethnic and linguistic and different people living in with a different culture in our country. As same like in Malaysia, I have find, you know, this is also one of the diverse countries in the world. And this government following the horizontal inequalities policies, which is successfully continuing in this country. So I found this is the better country, and I have experienced in a different environment with different diverse people in Sri Lanka. But in Malaysia, you know, this university and the people provide us equal chance, and they respect us. And at the same time, you see, I found at the UM, there are a number of students from the different part of the world, especially from Asia and this region, and African, many Middle East students are available at this university. So with the diverse students, I continue my study without problem.
I don't feel much difference from my country because first of all, the climate is totally the same. Raining, sun, everything is same. I have some friends from China and some kind of Europe countries. They don't feel much uncomfortable because in their country, the climate is totally changed. But fortunately for me as a Sri Lankan, the climate is okay with Malaysia. And the facilities what I am having in Malaysia, in University Malaya, all the facilities are free. For example, the gym, library, sports activities, everything is free for me.
When I compare with the economy and the price of the goods compared with the Sri Lanka and Malaysia, you know, it is a little bit high than Sri Lanka. So still it is manageable. In the initial stage, I stayed outside of the University of Malaya, you know, along with my friends. I found a cheap rate apartment and I do come to the university. And my later stage of my study, this is the period of I'll complete soon my study. So nowadays I'm staying at inside of the university at the 12th college of the university. This 12th college is an international house. There are a number of different diverse international students along with the Malaysian students residing over there.
Sri Lanka is a multicultural country. We live in Sri Lanka, Tamil, Sinhala, Muslim people are living together in Sri Lanka. Like Malaysia also a multicultural country. We have a special group, Sri Lankan Universities of UM. Especially we have a WhatsApp group to communicate among us. So I think nearly 40 to 50 members are there. Many girls, boys, even university lecturers from Sri Lanka, industry people, many types of people from many types of industries and academic sites, all are in UM. So even in language-wise, we are Tamil people here, Sinhala people here, Muslim people here. Even we have Buddhist monks here studying together in UM. Apart from that, we have a Facebook group, so where we share our ideas, and that's how we communicate each other. Right, so let's say a friend of us is coming from Sri Lanka to study in UM, we can communicate through Facebook and we can arrange his lodging by contacting him through WhatsApp and everything. So that's how we are communicating. It helped us really a lot, because we don't need to go a much troubled path, because they already know. From their experience, they are guiding us what's the next step we have to take.